I did not want to go into dirty financial stuff. However, the EU came up with the great idea of so-called Article 13, where practically they said to Google and to YouTube that, you know what, make it rain, baby, make it rain, give us all the money. And of course, the response from Google on the contrary was, you know what, as long as we are not making money on any of those channels which are not monetized, those channels are then just financial liability for us, so we're gonna get rid of it due to Article 13.
I have received these updated guidelines a good while ago, and to be honest with you, I did not really pay attention what will actually change in the 22nd of January 2019. And as it turns out, that is exactly the date when the new EU law, so-called Article 13, will go into then being enforced within the EU. To quickly summarize, what is this Article 13? That is practically saying, if whenever I would upload or whoever else would upload any kind of content to a website like, let us assume, YouTube or Facebook or something similar social media website, and this thing contains any type of copyrighted material, then the website itself would be responsible for any type of liabilities like lawyers, copyright strikes, and so forth and so forth. Of course, Google cannot take such a risk because there is no way to pay that amount of money. Most of the changes are summarized in points 6 and 7, where then they are talking about the copyright ownership and also that you must own all the licenses and all the rights whenever you are posting any kind of content. In point 7.7, they go that far that you have to make sure that whenever you upload something, this does not contain any kind of third-party material. If you read through these new guidelines, it does not contain any kind of hard statements written in black and white. I assume you would need to be a lawyer to fully understand what is in this material here. When you go through points 6, 7, and 8, and you are trying to read between the lines, the message I would say is the following. If you are a European and you are not making us any money, however you might put us in trouble whenever you upload something, then there is a high chance that we will not let you upload new things, or there is a high chance that we might even delete the full channel. As I said, this is not written here black and white because that is most likely not the statement what they clearly wanted to make. However, that is what I'm taking home after reading this stuff.
Of course, big YouTube channels are making lots of this good cash, so they don't care because they are making plenty of money. Their channels will not be deleted, but small channels like mine, especially if it's not monetized like mine, it will be then deleted most likely in January.
As a result of all these changes, practically I find myself between a rock and a hard place, so I don't really have any other options but to turn on monetization starting in like the second week of January and hope that at least they don't then nuke my channel. Since by now I have well over 10,000 subscribers, some of you might be wondering why I did not turn on monetization. And I have two reasons for that. The reason number one is that I look into this, namely whenever I upload a YouTube video, as a hobby, and I'm actually happy to get any kind of feedback from comments and such. I did not really look at it so far as making any money off it. On the other hand, the other problem is of course financial. So if you go to Social Blade, you can get a rough guesstimate of how much money your channel would be earning per month. As you see, my channel would be earning about 12 euros. This is before the so-called apocalypse. In reality, I would be earning about one half of this, which means that at best I would be earning about 6 euros per month with my channel. Therefore, give or take, my channel would produce about 70 euros over a full year, which might sound good. However, when you think about it, there is a catch-22, namely, I would then need to hire a tax accountant, and as I will show you, the tax accountant would cost me about 600 euros. First of all, I would need to set up a completely separate bank account, which is also working for online transactions. Currently, I pay about give or take 16 euros for such a bank account, so that is a reasonable amount of money. I'm willing to pay that, that's okay. However, the next one is the real tough cookie to swallow, namely if you have a full-time job, and luckily I do have a full-time job, so I'm not complaining. Next to a full-time job, any kind of other income is counted as a secondary income, so you would need to then hire a so-called Steuerberater, which is a special type of tax accountant. And these tax accountants, at least in my area, will charge you give or take 200 euros for a 90-minute session. I will need to have at least minimum 3 sessions with one of these specialists, and to add insult to injury, since I'm working full-time, it would mean that I will need to then use 3 of my holidays to actually go to this person. So the simple math looks like the following. I would spend about 16 euros on a bank account. I would spend about 600 euros on a tax accountant.
When it comes to 600 euros, for me that is actually a lot of money. So that is 100, that's 200, that's 3, 4, 5, 6. So yeah, I mean, this amount of money keeps on my heating, my light, and I can live somewhere and not over the bridge for about 3 weeks out of a month. So yeah, for me this is a substantial amount of money.
And I might earn about 70 euros over a year from YouTube revenue. Overall, it means that I'm losing only 546 euros. Yeah, anyway, I can live with that, it's an expensive hobby. As you see, this is why so far I was not even thinking about turning on monetization. So in practice now, this Article 13 is then forcing me to take this loss, or they gonna then delete my channel, and to be frank with you, I just put way too much work and effort into it to let it go. Of course, this will also force me then to produce more content and at least try to break even at the end of the year, which might be actually good for my subscribers. Please let me know in the comment section below, what do you think about this monetization? Should I turn it on, or if they delete the channel, then so be it.
As a completely unrelated side note, I actually prefer the good old American dollars. They are nice green, very well designed. And just look at this European stuff. I mean, all pink and purple and brown. I mean, yeah, this is really some funny money. I take the US dollars any day over this European BS, but that's just my private opinion. By the way, if you are wondering why do I have some cash, that is because it's the end of the month, so I need to pay my landlord. That's the only reason why I had to pony up the money.